an online petition started by MoveOn to impeach Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas has now surpassed 300,000 signatures in just a matter of days. So this petition, of course, calling for the impeachment, the removal or impeachment, let's be clear, of Clarence Thomas, unfortunately does not have any kind of legally binding, you know, attributes to it. So it's not like you hit a certain threshold and then Congress says, oh, dang it, we actually have to impeach him now because of this. But what it does is it sends a message to Congress and, of course, helps tell the story to the American public about why Clarence Thomas needs to be impeached. And the big reason that the MoveOn petition lists, in fact, for the record, it doesn't even list the overturning of Roe at all. It does not even mention that in the petition. So this is not a Roe thing. This is a Clarence Thomas is absolutely corrupted, mostly by his wife and her efforts to overturn the results of the 2020 election, and therefore needs to be removed from the court. So specifically, the main grievance is the fact that recently Clarence Thomas ruled in a case where the Supreme Court was basically trying to figure out if investigators could get their hands on Trump documents, you know, related to the 2020 election. Because of Clarence Thomas's wife's activities, I guess we'll call them, to overturn the results of the 2020 election, Justice Thomas should have recused himself, and he failed to do so. So that, of course, failure to recuse is a big thing with judges, right? That is absolutely something that leads to disciplinary action against judges all the time in this country. Because apparently it is a very big problem in this country because judges rarely recuse themselves even when they are legally required to do it. Now, having said that, it does not usually result in impeachment. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and clarify that and say that it literally never results in impeachment. Sometimes judges do, in fact, step down. Sure, that does happen. Impeachment does not. But I still support this petition. Because more than anything else, like I said, it sends this message to Congress. It sends the message that says we are sick and tired of the corruption on the United States Supreme Court. That Supreme Court has a confidence rating right now of less than 25%. 25%! A majority of people in this country actually support an investigation into Clarence Thomas. The public is with you. This petition, the numbers are growing by the day. Hell, by the time you watch this, it may have gone over 500,000 signatures. People want the man investigated because they know how corrupt he is. But any investigation, any impeachment would have to come from the House of Representatives to start. And given that it's an election year, I seriously doubt we're going to see any movement forward from the Democratic Party. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.